Rick Mastracchio is a native of Waterbury, Connecticut, and grew up there in the 1960s interested in the space program, but not with the idea that he'd ever fly in space himself.
When I was a small kid, I didn't know you could even be an astronaut. It never occurred to me I could be an astronaut someday. But I was always interested in math and science. I was always interested when the teacher spoke about aviation-related topics or space science-related topics, you know, when I was in grade school.
He took those interests to the University of Connecticut, the first person in his family ever to go to college, and earned a Bachelor of Science degree in Electrical Engineering and Computer Science, which got him a job at Hamilton Standard developing guidance and flight control systems while he finished a Master's of Science in Electrical Engineering at Rensselaer Polytechnic. At that time, he saw an ad from NASA looking for new astronauts and decided to apply. What he got was a job offer from Rockwell to work in shuttle operations, and he moved to Houston in 1987. 3 years later, he joined NASA as an engineer specializing in software development, then became a flight controller in ascent and entry guidance and procedures, and was selected as an astronaut in 1996 after 9 years of applying. His first space shuttle flight was the 2000 mission that outfitted the International Space Station's new Zvezda module for its first permanent crew. He made three spacewalks during his second trip to the station in 2007 on a mission that delivered a truss segment and a new gyroscope, and three more EVAs on a 2010 resupply mission. He sees this station as a means to support inevitable exploration well beyond the neighborhood of this blue planet.
We are meant to explore, we being the people here on this planet Earth. We want to go out and see what's out there. We want to know more about things, and we can't just do that through robotic systems. We have to send people to see things up close and personal.